Welcome back to FTL Faster Than Light. I'm just going to do another casual run. And the ship I'm going to pick today is the Rock A. This is another ship that I see people sometimes have problems with. And to be fair, it's kind of a difficult ship. You only have the missile weapons, so you are definitely trying to augment your offensive capabilities so you don't just straight up run out of missiles. And on hard mode, engines are going to be a little bit better on enemy ships, because on the first sector, they will man their engines for 5% extra evasion compared to what they'll normally have that early in the game. So it can be a little bit frustrating, but at the same time, it's still possible to usually win. So I'll try and just show off how to roll with the punches. So we'll name this to the Old Reliable. And no particular reason to rename any of these people. I guess I'll get rid of this character there. That's no particular reason for that to be there. So looks like we're ready to go. So we'll just see what we can do, and hopefully it goes smoothly. But not too smoothly. I don't want to have too easy a run, or else this will have no educational benefit whatsoever. Alright, these guys don't look too tough. They don't even have hacking. Always, anytime that you get a situation like this where you get to check out the enemy ship before you fight it, always, take a look at their systems, take a look at their weapons, get all the information you can, because you don't always have the choice of looking at them. But in this case, these guys don't look that hard. We can certainly do better than this. So, for the Rock A in particular, you want to measure how much health they have. Now, because we're playing on hard mode, enemies have slightly more hull than they would have otherwise. I'm fairly sure that if we were in normal mode, this would only have 6 hull instead of 7. But because they have 7, we don't have the a single hull missile to an empty spot and an Artemis to whatever isn't going to make 6 damage kill them yet. So basically, you have the choice of either using 2 hull missiles and just tanking this all this stuff and ignoring it to save one missile, or going ahead and using one extra missile just to be safe. In this case, we can't really shut off the missile, but if the missile hits our shields, then the laser could do a decent amount of work. I don't know. On the first battle, I'll usually go ahead and play it safe. This is not terrible, but at the same time, it's not like trivial either. So I will go ahead and use an extra missile here. But, again, it's worth doing the missile math before you start out. So in this case, I'm going to go ahead and fire the Artemis, just to get rid of this laser here. And we got very lucky there. But usually that won't happen. So in this case, yeah, since we already spent a missile, we might as well go ahead and spend another missile. Just get that all taken offline. And we'll go ahead and wait for our hull missile to hit this. They should hopefully be distracted by whatever's going on in here, so that this has a fairly good chance of landing. It's still Sector 1, after all. Enemy dodge isn't too good most of the time. Alright, so 21 scrap and nothing, but that's not too bad. At least it's a little bit better than what we did have. So, on hard mode, I've said this before and I'll say it again. You always want to buy this. There's some circumstances which you might want to buy something else, but you nearly always want to buy shield 1.5 as soon as you have that 20 scrap available. This just makes so many fights better when you have this buffer bar here, where you can get damaged once, but you still have a shield. That is so useful. Well, we're not going there, so I guess we're going here. Alright, another fight. This one's actually a better candidate, because the ions can be a little bit threatening, but they won't actually do hull damage to us. So this might actually be a good candidate to just take this missile straight on the chin. We do have rock plating, we do have full hull, so it's not the end of the world if we get hit by some missiles. So in that case, you probably want to shift this over so that this is true. Another subtle point is that sometimes you can tell what kind of missile this will be before it even fires. Enemy ships in Sector 1 usually only have a maximum of 3 weapons power. I don't think I've ever seen 4 weapons power in the first sector. So because you know that this is two weapons power, this has to be one weapons power in order to fit. If this were an Artemis missile, it'd be two weapons power, so it'd be a total of four. So it wouldn't fit. So it has to be one weapons power, which means it's only a leader. So that's no big deal. It's okay if we take some damage. And I don't think I actually care about that. If our shields were down, I might, but I don't think I actually care. Because we'll get to absorb one of these shots, at least. Alright, so about surrenders. It can be worthwhile to take some surrenders on this ship, because when you take a surrender, you'll tend to get more missiles sometimes from these high missile offers, and you don't have to spend another missile to actually hit their ship. Plus, there's certainly, you know, the chance that I could miss, so it actually could be more like spending two extra missiles. But in this case, seven scrap and one drone part is pathetic, so we're still not going to take this. I'd rather spend some more missiles to get some more scrap. Oh, we got lucky. Alright, so they did ionize our weapons by one, but they didn't take off the whole missile, which is what I actually wanted to shoot, so we're all good. Unfortunately, we're probably not going to dodge this missile. Alright, so that's fine. We took three damage there. Alright, well, we're going to take four damage, actually. I'm not going to bother moving him up. By the time he gets there, it'll be too late. Getting really lucky on these resists, though, actually. You know, I would be certainly fine with having taken, like, two more damage on this fight. Alright, so we did miss one, but certainly if we'd tried to shoot missiles anywhere else, we probably would have, you know, we certainly could have missed with any other chance as well, so it's not like it's the worst thing. So we were able to save a few missiles there and take a little bit of damage, but that's fine. You start with 30 hull, so you're expected to spend some of it if you get my meaning. You know, you gotta spend hull to get hull. So we're just going to go ahead and heal everybody up just to be safe. I definitely recommend that, even if it's a little bit boring, but it kind of helps you decompress at the end of a battle, too, just to kind of go over what went right and what went wrong. So just kind of a calm period in between battles, but we're fine for now, so let's move on. So let's see, it always is a good idea to check the map at the beginning of a sector, but in this case, it looks like we're pretty much free to go wherever. I think we're going to have a little bit more freedom of option if we go up this way, because we can still take this beacon and go down here if we need a little bit of extra space. So I'm just going to go up this way and fight some more battles up here. Alright, now in a situation like this, obviously you don't really need to worry about being missile efficient as much. In this case, also... Now this could be either a Leto missile or an Artemis missile, you can't tell. But it'll be obvious after a while has passed, of course. So once again, this isn't a particularly dangerous setup. If this were like a heavy laser, I might want to hit weapons, but because it's just a basic laser, I think I'm just going to ignore it and make sure that they don't get away. Sadly, that is an Artemis missile, but, you know, that these things happen. It looks like it's engines. Alright. We'll go ahead and... We just want to kill them as fast as possible, so we'll go ahead and use the hull missile here. Okay, the breach is good. We're probably going to get that repaired, so... But I don't think I want to wait for another hull missile, so I probably just want to go ahead and just use a missile on their weapons to get that benefit, and then use a hull missile to clean up. Okay, so... We have slightly more than... Like, this would be our second missile we'd fire. So I could shoot the Artemis at piloting instead. Keep that offline. It'll be repaired by the time this is ready, but at the same time, it will be broken slightly. Whereas if I ignore piloting entirely, they'll have full evasion. Well, I don't think I have to decide yet. Let's see where this missile is going to hit us first. Looks like it's going to be in the weapons. Okay. Well, in that case, I think we want to hit piloting. And then hope we can shoot another Artemis quickly enough. Okay, so we didn't get much time off of that, but at least we got a little bit. Come on. Alright, Yeah, that's not gonna fire in time, is it? Nope. That was worth a try. Hopefully we delayed them enough that we can still actually get that fired in time. I don't know. Well, probably not at this rate. Nope, that's just not gonna... They're gonna get away then, probably. Alright, well, not a heck of a lot we can do about that. Man, believe it or not, this is actually rock plating, like, being on fire today. It's doing great. Normally you don't get nearly as many resists. I'll mention this when we get to a store, but essentially, rock plating is just kind of a free bonus at the start of a run. You can make some arguments for keeping it, but it's generally just not worth it, and you'll want to sell it when you do get it to store. In any case, so that was a bit of bad luck. Normally that would have been fine. If they just hit other systems, then we would have been okay, but I'll go ahead and blame hard mode targeting for that. They're slightly less likely to hit empty rooms on hard mode than other rooms, and they will try to hit like the core systems of piloting, shields, engines, and weapons and whatnot, slightly more often than doors and sensors. Although they will still hit these some every now and then, of course. But it's just some waiting. The developers would have to go into more detail about exactly how it goes. But, okay, so it's not the end of the world, though. We're going to lose a little bit of money, but it's okay. Sector 1 doesn't really give you particularly good rewards anyway, so it's not like we're losing out on a whole lot. Oh, brother, it's this thing. So this is one of the worst things that can happen to you in Sector 1. If you don't have Tier 2 shields yet, this thing will cut your shields in half, rounded down. So if you don't have the Tier 2 shields, you will be shieldless for this battle. You need Tier 2 shields, like 4 bars, in order to have 2 bars left. But because it rounds against you, 3 bars isn't enough. Thankfully, they don't have drones themselves, so they won't be hitting us too hard. Problem is, they have the cloaking, of course, so they might even be able to just hit us with these lasers. The beam is gonna hit us no matter what, but not much we can do about that. Okay, thankfully they were pretty dumb with that. So we're just gonna have to go ahead and hit that. Alright, well, we'll try again. Now, one more mean thing about... Okay, I should have, yeah, because this is... Yeah, I should have just counted the timing on that. Okay, that was my fault. Could have been more careful about that. Should not have shot that yet, of course. Now, one more annoying thing about hard mode is that enemies are more likely to have subsystems. Yeah, I need to shoot this, too. And I'll wait on the Artemis this time. Anyway, like I said, this has both shields and cloaking. So there is no empty hole that I could have shot a whole missile at. So the best I could have done would be to kill this in 3 missiles, not 2. And once again, that's hard mode for you. Better chance of subsystems. The worst part of this is that you don't really even get any particularly good reward for this. I think this is just a medium reward, not a high reward. Alright, so let us go ahead and buy Tier 2 shields. I don't think that event can happen more than once. It might be able to, but that's terrifyingly rare, I think. Like, it's like one event in, like, I think you can get duplicates, or... You get the point. It's very rare. We're pretty unlikely to run into that again, but Tier 2 shields will let us take our time. And even though we got beat up a bit, we should be okay. Alright, well, nothing left to do but keep fighting some more battles. Yeah. That's pretty rough. Let's see what they're gonna hack first. Okay, Medbay. Don't care about that. In this case, we want to charge up the FTL drive for a little while, and then go ahead and raise our shields. This will give us a little bit of a head start on the FTL drive charging. Alright, how important is it to fix that? Kind of. Manning our weapons isn't really going to be that important, since we're not going to get that much of an advantage on their charge time anyway. And this is just about ready to fire, so I really would just prefer to get that fixed before this gets any worse. So yeah, I can ignore that. So now, I probably just want to go ahead and hit piloting with the missile. Now, I think these things are guaranteed to have shields, so this is one ship where you're never going to be able to use your whole missile to full advantage. Okay, good. That hit. So that guarantees that this one will hit. In this case, we probably want to go ahead and hit engines then. Okay, and that's breached. Very nice. So that means they'll never dodge again. In that case, probably hit weapons. It doesn't really matter at this point. And let's get out of here. And we'll recharge our oxygen a little bit too, sure. So we'll charge that up a little bit, then put our shields back up, and jump out of here. Alright, so not gonna lie, this is kind of rough so far, but we should still be able to pull out of this pretty well. I guess this is fine. We'll just go here. Sure. It's drone parts. Alright, well, that's fine. We'll either sell those or, get to, keep them. Doesn't really matter, but it's a nice bonus. So let's see. In this case, I think we're just gonna go ahead and jump to these two beacons and then jump out. Yeah. So you'll notice I'm paying absolutely no attention to my hull. I'll fix it later, but we're not going to be taking much more damage this sector, just because we've kind of already gotten most of the nasty fights out of the way. I don't expect we're going to be running into too many more ships with drones this sector, so it's really just going to be a matter of how well Sector 2 treats us. In this case, these are probably going to hurt us, but we might be able to save some missiles. We're getting low enough on hull that we might want to spend one missile on this anyway, although you can see we're running low on missiles already. But it's probably worth it, just because our hull's so low. If we had high hull, then I would just go ahead and take damage from these lasers, but because we're on low hull, we are going to have to spend more missiles, I think. In this case, I'll go ahead and vent this guy out of the system and send him back over to Dorse. Alright, got a little bit lucky there, not taking any damage, but that's all good. Right, so we might as well shoot the whole missile now while they're distracted. And one more ought to finish them off, hopefully. Good. Alright, two missiles and a firebomb. Alright. Well, that's basically store credit, although if we're really lucky and we find a ship that can't hurt us, we might be able to kill the crew off just with one missile with that. We'll see. We might be able to make that work. In any case, I don't think there's any rush to spend our scrap immediately. Level 2 engines should be fine for now. You could make an argument for buying level 3 engines in this particular position, but I think we kind of need to spend money at a store, so I'm not really feeling the need to go spend our money quite yet. Right, so we're just going to jump here and then the exit. I don't think there's any reason to mess around in this nebula. I don't think we're just going to have enough time for that. Deactivate. They've got hacking, and what looks to be like a heavy ion and a regular laser. I'm going to go ahead and try to download the data stores. There's a chance that we might get missiles from this, and as long as they don't hack our shields, then we're fine. So this should be a pretty safe battle, even if we do get into a fight. Alright, like I thought. So as long as... yeah, we are perfectly safe from this fight. Now, on the other hand, it will actually take us a few missiles to actually fight this. This is... Actually, it's going to take 4 missiles, actually. That's actually a lot. It might have actually been a good idea just to scrap it, come to think of it. Yeah, it might have actually just been a better idea just to scrap. Because I think this is, like, map data or something. Maybe I want to skip this, actually. No, we need to scrap for a store. I think we're just going to go ahead and do it. Anyway, so the way this is going to work is, once again, I'm going to hit piloting with the missile. Alright, it's out. I'm going to exclusively be firing my missiles while they're not firing the weapons. I don't want my missiles to hit their shots in midair. That would be really awful. So we're just going to take this nice and slow, because we have all the time we want to do this properly. Might as well go ahead and hit hacking. Thirteen. I was hoping we'd get some missiles back from that, but that's okay. At least we got fuel. Wasn't much, but, you know, it's better than nothing. We actually might be able to make one more nebula hop before we get out of here, so it's probably worthwhile. If we do get into a fight, it'll be an easy fight, so it's probably worth it. Yeah, this shouldn't be too bad. Now, again, it's kind of questionable, but the thing about this is, on hard mode, Sector 2 enemies won't give you any better rewards than Sector 1 enemies, so it's actually better to fight Sector 1 enemies than it is to fight Sector 2 enemies, because then you're just fighting worse enemies for the same reward. In this case, since we resisted that, I think we actually do want to go ahead and try and optimize our missile count here. So I'm just going to try and kill them with 2 missiles, see if we can get lucky in that regard. And hope they don't hit us in the weapons. Yeah, that's not so important. We'll fix it later. Alright, so we got a bit lucky there. Normally that would have been 4 damage, but in that case we actually saved a missile, so that's good. So that'll keep us going for a while. And yeah, we're in good shape. So, you know, the ship's got a few holes in it. It's fine. I think we're gonna go to civilian sector. Yeah, because we want stores. Yeah, so all in good time. We'll get this ship shaped, don't you worry. Alright, so this was a quest to deliver some drone parts, I believe. That's probably a good idea. We don't want to go into this nebula because there's no stores in there, so we want to go out in this way into this area of the sector. In this case, yeah, it could be bad, but it's probably better. Like, there's 2 different events that can happen here. You'll see. We're going to go there. Because it's going to be mostly free stuff, I think. Alright. In this case, this is a pretty awful payment. Sometimes it can be, like, a little bit better, but, in this case, we kind of need the money, so I think we're going to go ahead and take the payment. You can try and risk this to try and get a better payment, but frankly, we can't really afford to not get money right now, so I am going to go ahead and take it. Okay, yeah, we're going to go this way, because we need to get to the store, so distress it is. Alright, now in this case, this is, here's another example of something I was talking about on the forum just a while ago. Choices you should always take. If you try and do number 1, you have a chance of either being successfully getting them out, or taking damage. You don't want that, because taking damage, in particularly in our case, would be pretty bad, but you'll take damage and it's just kind of bad, but you're not going to get much scrap this way. If you take this route, you're going to get into a fight, which you want, because sometimes it's an easy fight, or you'll get just get free money. In either case, you're pretty unlikely to take as much damage taking this option than you will take the other option. The only reason you take this is if you're doing like a challenge run where you can't fight anybody or something like that. But almost all the time you want to take this one, just so you avoid like unavoidable damage from option one. So in this case we do get into a fight, but thankfully this is actually an easy fight. They can't hurt us, so this might actually be one case where our random drop might actually come in handy. So first of all, we're going to see who they're going to board us with. It is a Mantis. That's not too bad. He's going into the med bay. Very nice. In this case, we probably don't actually want to kill him. Yeah, we don't actually want to kill this guy. We just want him to teleport back when he's low on health. We're going to send a pilot over to go into the scanners, because we need to take a look at the rest of the crew. So actually, yeah, you get out of there. You don't have any particular reason to be in there. You just have to beat him up. Okay, so the last one is an NG. Interesting. So, ideally what we would want to do is set fire to the clone bay and set fire to the... No, wait, we wouldn't want to set fire... We want to set fire to the oxygen. Yeah, because this guy will be too low on health to repair. Or hold on, we might be able to finagle this correctly. But we don't want to kill him. Yeah, that'll do. And hopefully, what I'm going to try and do is manipulate the AI. I want the NG to board us. And I think if we just wait here, with everybody alive, I think the NG will go board us once the teleporter goes off cooldown. Yes, good. Okay. Now, everybody get into the shield room and kill that guy as fast as possible. Right? Yeah, right. Or no, we might not actually want to kill him either. No, I think that might actually not be over. Yeah, so I think we want the NG to come back hurt, just like we did the other guy. Alright, so now everybody get out of there. And you just keep them distracted. Okay, good. Now, you get back onto there so you can see what we're doing. Now, the goal here is that since they've got a clone bay instead of a med bay, they're all going to be low on health. So now when I fire the firebomb into the oxygen, they're going to be too hurt to actually put it out. Yeah, so you can see neither of them are fighting it because they are too hurt. So what's going to happen is now the oxygen's going to just get broken. They're going to run out of air. They'll all die. And then we'll destroy the clone bay. So you get over to the scanners, because now we need to time this correctly. So they will run out of air, everyone will die, and we'll blow this up, because nobody will be piloting the ship at that point. So this will have a very good chance of landing. There's no particular reason to do this, but, you know, just to give our whole missile just a little bit more work to do. I'm just gonna go ahead and do that. In this case, yeah, so we'll put pilot in there, engines are already there, and you there. Okay. Now again, I don't usually do, crew training here. In fact, yeah, you get there, you get here. I usually don't farm skills, but because I'm waiting for these guys to die anyway, I might as well just put someone on piloting, someone on engines, just to get a tiny bit of crew training off of this thing. So, I guess I'll be back when my plan has come to fruition, and I will keep an eye on the oxygen to make sure these guys don't choke out either. Wow, that was incredibly lucky. But this is exactly the kind of reward that explains why we do this kind of thing. Obviously, there is no particular reason we should have gotten this, but we could have gotten another crew, we could have gotten good scrap, could have gotten a drone or something. Well, maybe not a drone, but we could have gotten really good rewards out of this, and this is one of the best ones. So there you have it. So now we don't even have to go to a store to buy something like this, we already have it. And there's a store, so let's go ahead and repair. Alright, so we're gonna go ahead and sell our rock plating. The reason for this is kind of twofold. Rock plating is only good for two things: resisting hull damage, and there's a specific blue option in a specific event, the crystal distress call in an asteroid field, where you can guarantee that you find a crystal ship, and in so doing, find a free weapon. Thankfully, we already have a free weapon. And, frankly, the 40 scrap for just getting this and then spending that 40 scrap on something else in our ship is better than randomly resisting damage. The rock plating did a great job up until now, but it's just, it's past its time. We need to get rid of it. Now then, I think we're going to get rid of the hull missile too, just because we got the flat gun now. So I just don't think we need it anymore. We'll keep the firebomb though, we might be able to make that work somehow, although we're so low on missiles though. We might not need it either. Anyway, let's see what we've got to buy. We've got a crew teleporter. That's actually a very interesting option. So what that means is we can turn this into a boarding ship. And I don't see any other weapons here in the shop, so I think that's what we're going to go ahead and do. Because with the Artemis missile and the flat gun, we have actually pretty good boarding support. And the firebomb will eventually come into its own as well. So I think that's what we're going to do. We're going to turn this into a boarding ship. That's kind of your default plan if you don't get any weapons at all, is what you'll do is you'll buy the crew teleporter, because then you'll only use 1 to 2 missiles per battle instead of like 4 or 5. Because you can see that you can really efficiently make use of your weapons in that way. So, yeah, like you can, well, we barely got any drone parts for hacking because we just sold a bunch of them. Right, I don't think you even start with that many drone parts, actually. So let's see, is there anything I'd want to do that's not this? That's another question you want to always ask yourself is, there's like an obvious plan, but is there anything else we could do that's not the plan? In this case, I don't think so, not really. So go ahead and do that. I don't think there's any reason to sell our weapons, so I'll go ahead and buy some fuel, make sure we don't run out, go above 10, that's usually a good idea. And we'll fix up to 20. We don't really have particularly good defenses, so it's a good idea to fix up a little bit more. Alright, so now we aren't going to need much power. We're only going to need something like this, or possibly that, to start out with. So in this case, I'm going to buy the engines first, to give ourselves more of a chance to put all of our energy in here if we want to. And otherwise, yes, we'll do this first, then we'll buy power later. We could buy more repairs at the store if we wanted to. It's not a terrible idea, because we're going to be taking more damage. It's cheap now. We don't particularly need more power yet, so it's probably a good idea. Yeah, just to be safe. Alright, so thankfully our bad luck earlier in the game has been balanced out by good luck now, so we're in good shape to continue. Obviously, we didn't need that flak from this fight. We could have just bought that teleporter without that, and we would have been fine. We could have repaired, we would have been fine. Sword could have been here, we would have been fine. So we got a little bit unlucky, but we should be back on track. You don't need the flak guns, what I'm trying to emphasize here. We certainly could have made it like a lot further into this run before like the game took pity on us, and we still would have been okay. That's not too bad. We should be able to just beat these guys up, so let's go ahead and do it. I forgot to actually put those guys in the teleporter, but that's alright. So in this case, we shouldn't need any support weapons. In theory, you could Artemis their missiles, or flak them even, but there's no reason to. I'm just gonna put it all into dodge instead, see what we can do. In this case, I'm gonna go ahead and board into probably weapons, because they're only going to have 2 crew, and I want to make sure that we get the first hit on them as they run in. Yeah, in this case, we got a little bit of extra 2-versus-1 time on that human there, so that should help us a bit. We could turn off our shields. Yeah, I'm going to go ahead and do that, just so that they don't get ionized too much. Alright, so they hit our shields anyway, but that's not a big deal. It's better than all 3 of them hitting the shields. Alright, so now what's going to happen is these guys, yeah, this one's dead, so now they'll team up on him and they'll certainly beat him. And there you go, easy fight. Take no damage, get 20 scrap, get plenty of fuel, I'm all for that. So let's see, we could probably do with one more power, just because it'll make it less awkward to power the flak and all of this at the same time. So, yeah, I'd say that's fair. Probably need that one too. Okay. So, at least one nice little consideration is, I think the developers did kind of anticipate that you might want to do this, have a boarding crew like this. So the teleporter is right next to the med bay, which is quite convenient. So we'll probably run like this, and yeah, have two engines put the oxygen power to the teleporter. Alright, so it should smooth itself out pretty well from here on out. Eventually we'll get the Artemis or the Firebomb available when we need it, but for right now we kind of don't, because these guys just keep forgetting to have med bays. In this case, they can't even hurt us. Here's an infamous, slug pirate in Sector 2 that has two shields. But thankfully, the Rock A is like the one ship where you don't really have to worry about that. Even if you're using missiles, this isn't such a big deal. In fact, it actually means that they'll probably have less evasion than normal. In this case, they probably have... they might even have four crew. We'll see. Nope, just three. That's fine. Alright, so you have to be a little bit careful, because they've got the Mantis here. Our Rockman should be able to live long enough. Okay, I'm just going to go ahead and, just to be safe, I'm going to swap places. I'm going to put a higher health crewman fighting the Mantis, just to make sure I've got enough time to pull these guys out if I have to. They're not going to be able to hurt us at all, so really it's just a matter of patience. Alright, who is our last crewman? It's another Mantis. Alright, we're pulling out. And we'll come back and fight him later. And again, always be sure when you're messing with your power to make sure you have free power for restoring your ionized power. You can get into trouble if, like, your shields don't automatically come back on after the ion wears off. So always just steal from, like, oxygen or engines. It's usually a good one. So you can see we had our flak powered. We didn't even really need it for anything. I mean, we could have been firing our flak at their weapons, but we just don't need to. Alright, two Rockmen can kill a Mantis, no problem. And in the meantime, our pilot is hopefully getting a little bit better at dodging. Just a little bit. Alright. Okay. So this is another case where I think this is actually an interesting decision. I think you only get one extra beacon from this. So basically the gamble here is, if you destroy this, you get low scrap immediately. Whereas if you take the gambling option, you get one more jump in the sector, and you're hoping that that extra jump gives you more than just a low scrap award. In most cases it will, but obviously it'll take you more fuel to do that. We've got plenty of fuel now. So this could be worthwhile. We do have enough of the sector left that we could get some benefit out of it. I might as well try it, just to gather some data. So, there we go. Let's not do that. That would be bad. Alright, so I'll heal them up, and then I'll come right back. I guess we'll buy one more power. It would help. Yeah, we could get some use out of that. So you can see that we're a little bit unbalanced right now. We are boarding them, but we don't have particularly, we don't really have any kind of boarding support on our own ship, particularly, but enemies just aren't going to have that many boarders in this early of a sector. They might board us with one boarder, and that would be it. Yeah, so we're all fine. It's all good. So we're going to get an extra jump in this sector, which means we'll probably be able to get one of these jumps up here that we wouldn't have been able to otherwise. In fact, we might even be able to get this one. We'll see. Or this one. So we'll go down here and get as much as we can, and hopefully this will pay off. We'll have to see, though. and there's a storm. Okay, I was kind of worried about that. We're gonna have to skip that beacon, but hopefully that means we'll still be able to get as many beacons as we want. Because we'll skip this. This is like the second store in the sector, so we might be able to visit all seven of these, maybe, and the exit. So we'll see. We'll just have to see. Like, this is here, that's good. This is all kind of flattened out. So we're gonna jump here, 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 and here, and maybe we'll be able to jump here. That's what I'm hoping. Yeah, so probably the best time to take that delay the fleet option is when you have beacons, like, behind the exit that you can jump to. Like, just extra beacons back here. That's probably the best time. And as it turns out, there's actually three stores in this sector, so that's actually even more annoying. So, yeah, it's probably better to just take the low scrap then. Oh well, that's alright. Like I said, it's early in the game, so decisions like that aren't really going to hurt us too much. It's later in the game when you really need to be focused on getting scrap from every single beacon, because you could be missing out on more scrap on each beacon. Could be like 30 or 40 scrap you're missing out on instead of just 10. Let's see, how are we doing? We're still pretty much on time, essentially. Like, normally we'd go to this, but it's a store, so we're not really that interested. Although we could. We'll have to see. If we have 80 scrap, I might actually consider it. On the other hand, we might just want to buy more defenses now. That's not wrong. Like, we could just buy more engines. I don't see us buying anything at the store, really. Like, even if it's a burst laser 2, I think we can just live until Sector 3 on what we've got now. So I think we just really want to bolster our defenses. Although, buying a, like, saving up 85 to buy a defense drone 1 is actually not a bad idea either. I don't know. We're doing okay for now. The engine value is pretty marginal. Like, it does help, but at the same time, I think we can get away with it without it for now. So we're just gonna try and tough it out. See if we can save up some more money. Sure. Okay, in this case, like, the scrap value is alright with all those previous considerations, but because we're boarding, we kind of want more crew. So we'll go ahead and invite him to join our crew. And it's another Rockman, naturally. So in this case, he doesn't have any skills, you don't have any skills, so I don't know. Might as well just put our already trained guy on the piloting, sure. So what this does is it actually gives us more boarders. It gives us the option of just boarding with a third Rockman and having our pilot still be here, or we can have a second entire party at all and just have four Rockmen on the mission. So that's obviously pretty good. Kind of wish it was someone else like a Mantis or a Human or NG, that would have been good, but a fourth Rockman is fine too. So yeah, still kind of feeling like we're ahead of the curve, but, I mean, ahead of the jumps. Like, we got one jump more than we actually need, but, eh, that's okay. Sure, okay. So this is good. Normally you run into this and you can't board them, but in this case, we should be able to board them quite handily. They've already got two power in this, so hopefully they don't have an anti-personnel drone. Let's just go ahead and board in here and see. No, they don't have any other drones. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to move you over to engines. We aren't going to be able to dodge this bomb as well, but I would like to just be able to drop another Rockman in there, like, immediately. In fact, I'm going to... Yeah, I'll go ahead and hit the weapons, just to be sure. Alright, well, it was worth a try. That could have been... Go ahead and hit them again. And drop a third one in there. Alright, so yeah, they're not getting away now. Nope. Alright, let's crack it open and see what we got. A hull missile, naturally. Well, I guess they must have bought that from the store. They must have wondered, you know, what the amazing new rock invention was. Well, it's just a hull missile. Alright, well, we got it back, for better or for worse. We're probably just going to sell it again, but at least we have it for now. Alright, well, with that in mind, we might actually be able to go to the store now that we have store credit. Yeah. I guess... Yeah, I think we're just going to save all our money for the store, because we're probably just going to go to it. We've got the time. At least I think we've got the time to go there. Okay. So here's another thing. We probably don't want to board this. Well, actually we could. Well, See, there's a Sector 2. Now this 3 power argument no longer applies. They could have a heavy ion and an Artemis missile. In that case, we would no longer be, certain guarantees would no longer apply. If we knew for certain this was a Leto missile, then I would go ahead and board, because we would be guaranteed to shut it off with our first damage. But because this could be an Artemis missile, we are not guaranteed to shut it off. So instead, I'm just going to go ahead and do the boring thing and shoot it down with our flak gun. Okay, it's a Leto missile, which means that we could actually board it. Alright, so if this doesn't take it offline, then I'll, now I'll consider boarding. But I'm gonna do it at a very specific time. Hopefully this takes it off and I don't have to bother. Okay, good. What I was gonna do is, if that missed, then... Oh. Well, that's weird. Okay, well, I'm not gonna board now. Because the idea is that 2 crewmen are guaranteed to do 1 system point of damage faster than 8 seconds, which is faster than these things fire. I think it's about 7 seconds. I don't care. That's fine. I could load up the Artemis missile to make this go faster, but I don't care. I've got plenty of hull. This is okay. In this case, now I think I will go ahead. Ah, okay, I mistimed it. If I timed it better, they would have broken that before it fired. Thankfully, they didn't hit our teleporter. That's why you have to be very careful of this. So, technically, I could have killed these guys, but I knew it was pretty unlikely. Still, it was a good idea to be careful about it. In this case, we shouldn't need to dodge anymore, so we should be okay. And the level 1 teleporter will rescue the Rockman before they suffocate. In this case, I'm going to go ahead and... I'm going to wait a little tiny bit longer. Now I'm going to fire this. Now I'm going to rescue them. I need to put them in the medbay real fast because we're out of oxygen, actually. Oh well, being a little bit naughty about this. He should get this fixed up nicely, though. We gotta pay a little bit more attention to the oxygen than I have been. But it's okay. We're fine. Rockmen can hold their breath for quite a long time. Yeah, see? Everybody's fine. It's okay. And we got a backup DNA bank. I don't know why that auto ship had it, but, now we have it. Sure. You're fine now, you get out. I guess you can go over here or something. And, you know what, I'll tell you what, I'll see you back when everything's fixed. We're gonna be here a little while. Alright, we've got our oxygen back up to actually acceptable levels now, so let us go here and then go to the store, I think. I think we're going to have just barely enough time to go there and out, so actually it ended up working out for the better. I wasn't expecting us to have this much store credit, but there you go. No, we will never surrender one of our crew to slavers, no matter how well-armed they are. Alright, that's not entirely true. I'll surrender our crew to slavers if we really absolutely have to save the mission. But otherwise we won't. Alright, so I'm just gonna go ahead and let one of them board us. And now I'm gonna board the engines. Let's see, where are they? They're in the teleporter. Okay. Well, I'm just gonna... I'll go ahead and vend him. I'm not gonna vend him immediately, though. I'm gonna let him be up the teleporter just for a little while. And then I'm gonna vend him. Just so he doesn't go into a bad place too quickly. Alright, luckily their crew is pretty weak, so we'll definitely beat them head on, that's for sure. Alright, that takes care of them, and we will definitely have momentum on our side in a hurry. So essentially the big idea here is they're going to be way too busy healing their crew to ever actually get the... In fact, technically we don't even need to shoot the medbay. I'll do that just to speed this battle up a bit, but... We should not really need to do that. In principle, we would have been able to do it even if, like, even without the flak, even without a missile. We would have been able to take them out even without any of that. But we've got a flak, so might as well make it easier on ourselves. If you want to learn how to take out a medbay without any kind of support weapon at all, play the Mantis B or the Federation C. I guarantee it'll be a fun time as far as really having to stretch out everything you can do with boarding. In this case, we got another wonderful reward. In fact, we'd probably want to keep you on piloting, probably. I mean, maybe we want to keep you loose as a repairman rather than the Rockman, actually. Like put you on piloting. Like, Charlie on piloting, you guys all boarding, and then have you on engines just so you can repair. That's probably a little bit better. We'll do that until we get a, until we get an NG. Like, I'd like to have, just, again, four Rockmen just free to board, but we can't do that quite yet. We'll be able to do it soon, I think, but we're not quite there. Not to, of course, look a gift human in the mouth, but, it's not quite as perfect as having, like, an extra Mantis or an extra Rockman would be. But we'll get there. We'll find a good use for this human. In this case, to make you be free, I guess you want to get on weapons and then you get on engines. Yeah, that makes sense. Alright, so we've got 82 raw scrap, plus we've got stuff to sell, and we've got time to jump to the store and get out of here. So I guess delaying that rebel fleet actually did pay off after all. Okay, well, we've got pretty good choices here. So we've got drone control with no defense drones, so not as exciting. We've got mind control. What do we got here? Nothing really. Like, I barely ever buy crew. Sometimes I'll buy crew on NGB, and maybe I might buy crew on Mantis B sometimes, but it's pretty rare. Crew are just so expensive. You can almost always get better use out of that money just buying something on your ship instead. Alright, so we're not keeping the whole missile. Like, as funny as that would be, we're not doing it. And I don't anticipate... Well, we're not buying a clone bay right this second, so we're not buying... We're not keeping the backup DNA bank either. So what do we buy? We don't buy the flak 2. That's too slow for this early in the game. It's much better purchased later in the game, but we don't need it right now. The burst laser 1 is a good... It's solid. Like, that makes it easier to take down auto ships. That just gives us more firepower. It's pretty solid. This would be... That's definitely what I'm thinking about. Either backup battery or mind control would be fine here, too. Like, this synergizes with a lot of what we're already doing. Backup battery is pretty much always good. Like, you can't really go too wrong here. Like, breach bomb is fine, too, but we don't really need it. We've got boarding support options already. We don't need a breach 2 bomb. That's redundant. So that would be a waste of money. We're not buying that. So either the burst laser or the mind control. I don't think we're going to buy both. Like, I think we only buy one of these and spend the rest on defense. So, like, that's pretty iffy. Like, burst laser one's not bad. Like that's really it. Is like, it makes it easier to fight auto ships, and it makes it easier to take down Zoltan shields, and it makes it easier to do things that aren't boarding, so I'm slightly more tempted to just go ahead with this. So I think I'm going to go ahead and do that. We'll buy mind control later. Or we could buy it now, though. Like, that is an option. We could just buy it now and get the burst laser 1 up later. That's certainly fine. We're about to jump into Sector 3, and we can raise our defenses. So I think just having better offense would be better. Yeah, I'd say that's fair. I'd say this is fine. So no backup battery this time, right? Yeah, we're not really selling. We're not selling the rest of these. These will all be fine later. Like, I would be perfectly okay with just upgrading my weapon system to run all four of these at the same time. That would be fine. So that's all good. So we're fine on hull. We could buy a little hull. It's not that bad though. We're still in the realm of, we don't have missile defense yet, so it's probably fine. I'll go ahead and tell you what, I'm going to buy 2 fuel and repair once, and call it good. Okay, now we're in good shape. Sure, yeah, we'll go ahead and attack those rebels. Alright. So in this case, yeah, here's what I'm going to do. I'm going to board into shields. I'm going to mind control one of these guys and... I'm going to wait in here. I did that wrong. Okay, well, it's fine. Alright, so here's what I'm doing. This guy is going to distract them in the shields room because shields is the highest priority. Now, everybody is out of there. That's their entire crew. So nobody is flying the ship. So that gives the Flak and the Artemis a much better chance to actually land. And in this case, I'm going to go ahead and hit our own crew. It's fine. So we hit our own crew, but that's okay. I just wanted to get that offline as fast as possible. It did fire once, so I would have been fine. But I just wanted to make sure that, like, if, like, literally none of that hit. So now, we don't need anybody else on our ship, so in fact, you go here, and you guys just get in the teleporter, too. And there you have it. Very well executed. Yeah, these guys don't stand a chance. Alright, in this case, everybody is safe. Nobody's inside the cloning bay because I don't have one. So I'm going to go ahead and steal the civilian supplies. I know it's really rude, but it is positive expected value, so I have to do it. Alright, well, nothing happened, but, I'm sure these guys just, gave it back. Right, guys? Right, guys? Alright, so moving right along from that, we're going to go ahead and heal up, and we should be able to just jump out of the sector. So we are actually in really good shape. We've got all the offense we really need for a while, actually. We've got the missile to pierce shields, we've got flak and burst laser to save on missiles. We actually have a pretty decent number of missiles again, because we've been saving them. So we're in good shape. All we need to do is buy defense now. So definitely on the docket is tier 3 shields, level 4 or 5 engines, and defense drone or cloaking. Probably defense drone. But, we'll see. So, we'll just have to see what the next sector brings us. We're probably gonna go to the NG homeworlds, because we have Rockmen and, just Rockmen and Mind Control, but we might get some free stuff there, and everybody likes free stuff, so we're definitely going to the NG homeworlds.